Hey guys, welcome to the Delta Flyers. This week's special guest interview is none other than Lolita Faggio, who has been connected with the Star Trek world since the beginning of time, practically. Robbie is not here because he is directing right now. So I am the one that is running this interview. So we apologize for not having Robbie here, but he's so swamped right now on Turner and Hooch. So that's something.
Well, that's okay. He's here in spirit.
He's here in spirit. Yep. Let's talk about your involvement with the documentary.
All right.
First of all, I have to ask, did you work with 455 when they did the DS9 documentary?
Yes, I did. I absolutely worked with them on the DS9 documentary, but not to the extent that I'm involved with the Voyager documentary.
Okay.
The DS9 documentary, I was their talent coordinator.
And then with the Voyager documentary, you're still acting as a talent representation or talent manager, but what are your added responsibilities with the Voyager documentary?
Well, I'm a producer as well. So it just means being involved in a lot of different aspects that I've never knew anything about. I've never worked on a crowdfunding campaign before. Mm-hmm. And I've learned a lot. I mean, I'm still an observer. I'm not the one running the campaign by any means, but it's been really interesting to have a say in all of that, and creating the perks for the Indiegogo campaign has been a lot of fun, because a lot of that, as you know, includes the actors.
And I know that there's now a name for the documentary,
yes.
Correct?
Yes, finally, it's To the Journey, Looking Back at Star Trek Voyager.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Beautiful. I have to be perfectly honest. I was very excited to hear from you when you called me up and said, listen, 455 is going to be filming on the Star Trek cruise, and they really want you to be a big part of this. And I'm like,
absolutely.
Oh, that's pretty cool. We did do quite a bit of filming on that cruise. I had the crew follow me around as I interviewed different fans on the deck and everything like that. I did that.
And it worked out so well. And we're so lucky. For those of you who don't know, the only real filming that we got to do last year for the Voyager documentary was on Star Trek, the cruise. And thank God, because the minute we got off that ship on March 8th, the world shut down. Finally, probably by the summertime, 455, we started meeting again and said, we really need to keep going. We can't let this stop us. So we were actually able to get a few in-person interviews in the last few months.
And when you talked about the few one-on-ones that they were able to get at the beginning of the pandemic, I was one of them.
And we were able to get Robbie McNeil. Mm. Obviously, we can't miss Jerry. She was an integral part of creating this show.
Yeah.
Without Michael around. And we also have Rick Berman, who's going to give us a one-on-one as soon as we can travel to him. So we're really excited about the next few months here.
Let's just talk a little bit about where we're at with the documentary. I think the tally as of the beginning of this, you just checked the numbers before we began recording this, mm-hmm. and it was at $914,773. I'm sure it's gone up a little bit since then.
A total of
well over 8,000 donations, right? Different
backers.
Over 8,000 backers,
amazing.
Which is incredible. Well, have we surpassed Bill Nye then? We've passed.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah. So yep.
At one point, there are two other documentaries that were beating in terms of record of crowdfunding, right?
That's right.
And the Bill Nye was one that was ahead of us. And the other one was the Frank Zappa documentary, right?
And it's still ahead of us.
It's still ahead of us.
I know we're going to beat it. We're going to beat it. We've got, 8 days left? And with the fans are so generous, we're adding new perks. We just added one last week that is almost sold out. Something I put together with Casey Biggs from Deep Space Nine. So we put together a day in Paso Robles with wine tasting with Casey and a private concert with the Enterprise Blues Band. There's some pretty unique things. I'm really proud of what we've put together for this. We've got dinners still that are available in Los Angeles with Jimmy Darren and all kinds of stuff. So if any of you fans haven't had a chance to look at the Indiegogo site, please do. There might be something that would really catch your eye. Things are going really well. And I can imagine within, 8 days, 7 days that we won't beat Frank Zappa. So,
what's Zappa at? I'm wondering what the
I knew the other day and I didn't look it up today.
Okay.
I want to say it was 1,000,126, because we were laughing and saying if we could get to 1,000,127, that would do it. So come on, something guys. Like that. Yeah.
Come on, guys. If you're watching this right now on the Delta Flyers, that is your call to action. We need to beat $1,106 or whatever it is, right?
Exactly. Exactly. Possible. Yeah. And then kind of on a serious note, it would be so cool to have Voyager be that number one
spot. The number one crowdfunded documentary in the history of crowdfunding would be absolutely stellar, right?
And also for Dave Zappone, who is the owner and our leader at 455 Productions, he's put in so many hours on all these documentaries with the Captains and the Spock documentary. I would love to see that happen for Dave.
Yeah, Dave, what an incredible guy. I mean, he's been doing this for so many years. I'm really excited. I hope that we do break the barrier and become the number one crowdfunded documentary of all time. That would be wonderful. So everyone, just please go to Indiegogo and check out some of those new perks that are there. The end of the crowdfunding will be the last day of March, essentially, right?
Well, I believe we have till April 1st.
Till April 1st. Okay, April Fool's Day. Okay, so we have until April Fool's Day. And hopefully we will break that level that is so close.
I think we have two associate producers left to donate. Okay. And those associate producers get a lot of things included in that. So
a lot of perks. Yeah.
A lot of perks. Basically, they get almost everything that we have to offer. The away missions and any other type of in-person perk will not be scheduled until a year from now. Basically, we'll start scheduling them for the spring and summer of 2022.
Got it.
A lot of the other perks that are Zoom calls with actors and things that we'll send to you, those will be scheduled obviously much earlier. We're actually going to start with the Zoom calls in April and May.
Yes.
So the in-person ones will be next spring and summer.
Right. Oh, and also the perk that Delta Flyers donated, that was snapped up in a split second.
Yes, it was. Very quickly.
Right. Any other words, final words regarding the documentary?
I've just really been so not surprised, because Voyager and Star Trek fans are just phenomenal. And quite honestly, when we decided to start this crowdfunding during COVID, during the height of the lockdown, we knew that it could go one of two ways. But these Star Trek fans have obviously just been so supportive. I mean, I can't wait to even start filming these one-on-ones again, just to get out and do it. So if a few more of you can get out there and donate in the next 8 days, that'd be fabulous. And keep looking at the Indiegogo site every day. There's always something new little things, some great t-shirts now, just some fun stuff.
And other than the Indiegogo, after the Indiegogo campaign shuts down, for fans to get new information on the documentary or new developments or whatever, or progress reports. Facebook, there's a Facebook page, there's Twitter, right?
Yeah, and there's a Voyager YouTube also.
Voyager documentary YouTube channel and Instagram page as well.
Instagram. Right?
So pretty much every social media platform. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us your knowledge and talking about the documentary. I look forward to the day that the fans get to see this.
Absolutely. Thanks so much to you, and say hi to Robbie.
Will do. All right. Thanks, Lolita.
All right.